Now, I think I have just the right thing for a lady sergeant in the United States Marine Corps. Open those doors!
A handy vacuum and a new refrigerator. First, the Hoover Porta Power Stick Pack.
I didn't mean that. Wait, just keep listening. It'll make sense in a minute.
First, the Hoover Porta Power Stick Vac with attached tools and easy, empty dirt cup. Nobody gets the dirt like Hoover, nobody. And second, a refrigerator. This dependable top-mount dual-cool refrigerator from Maytag is specially designed to provide consistent temperatures, keeping your food fresher longer from Maytag. And finally, to make sense of this...
This is what I meant.
A new car!
Most of us have recovered enough to go on, Rod. Who's our next player?
Well, let's see what we can do for Aaron Sturdivant. Come on down. Aaron, you're the next contestant on The Price is Right.
You're the man, Bob. Oh, my, you're my idol.
I have the horrible feeling I have another one. Here's the next item up for bid. Yes. Give us a number lower than 4.
Oh, Aaron, I'm sorry.
Oh. I gotta spin the wheel, right?
That's right. He'll spin the wheel.
Now, Aaron, if you don't go over, you win. No matter how far you miss it. Your bid is $26,500. Aaron, the actual retail price of your showcase is $26,368. You're over. Oh, and by so little, by $32. Isn't that right? About $132. About, like, not much.
Howdy, Justin.
This is the car stage.
Now, just a moment. A very interesting remark. What did you say?
This is the car stage. Me and my friend Tony know this is the car stage. We got the car, Bob.
Now, you are implying by that remark that we only give cars from here.
No, but it's a good principle. Good percentage.
Is it a good
percentage? Good percentage. I mean, I watch the show all the time. I take my lunch break for the show. I told my brother I'd get on.
Well, here he's... I hate to... You know, it's going to be a disappointment now. But go ahead, show him
new cookware. Commercial grade cookware, durable, oven proof and easy to clean, non-stick inside and out, and cooks flavorful meals without butter, oil or sprays from AmeriWare. Or how about this new sports car?
There it is. $8,000. $8,000. Oh, are you going for 16 or are you going to quit?
Yeah, I'm going to go.
All right, she's going on. If that pizza's in this bag, she wins $16,000. If the pizza's not in the bag, you lose your $8,000. You know that. Very well, we're looking for pizza. Let's show the price of the dinnerware and audience, please do not try to help us. Cool, please. Paige, remove that man. Now.
I want to say $59.40.
He says $59.40 is the right price. Does he own the sauna? We'll never know. There. I wish we could not have got it off.
Austin,
Johnny, let's go on. Let's get another contestant out of this studio audience.
Let's do, Bob.
Patricia Bernard, come on down. You're the next contestant on The Price is Right. Just a moment. An emergency has occurred. Would you believe this moment had to occur, did it not? Patricia has gone to the little girl's room. Now, I have a suggestion. Patricia has gone to the little girl's room. She can't come to us. Let's all go to Patricia. Here we go. Now, I tell you what we might do. Is it going to take a long time? I mean, she's on her way back. Does anyone hear footsteps in the hallway? A gentleman, whom I assume is her husband, has rushed out to get her. A page has gone after the gentleman. Everyone in America is wondering how long can they wait for Patricia. Somehow we'll make this time up. My only worry is, will Patricia make it up here? No one's coming back at all. Is she coming? Do you hear her? No, wait. I got a report. Here comes her. Are you her husband? Here comes Patricia. Next item up for bids and The Price is Right.
It's a water bed.
A heated Nimbus water bed with matching bookcase, headboard, and rich walnut finish helps survive an easy night's sleep, complete comfort, support, and relaxation on a Nimbus water bed. With her in this condition, wouldn't you know it'd be a water bed? The actual retail price is $566.24. Florence, will you come right over here? I do believe. Florence.
Oh, my God.
Yes. That's the same thing I said when she hit me in the head. She bumped my head here and hit the other side of my head here.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Florence. I hope you're having fun so far.
John, what's the name of our next player?
Bob is Sherry Pie Snow. Come on down. You're the next contestant on The Price is Right.
Hello, Sherry.
Hi there, Bob.
Your name is Sherry Pie?
Yes, sir.
Sherry Pie, tell us about that.
Well, when my mom was carrying me for 9 months, she craved cherry pie the whole 9 months, so she had nothing alternative but to name me Sherry Pie.
I think that's great, but why didn't she name you Cherry Pie?
Because it wouldn't be true.
I am so stupid, aren't I? I stand up here so many hours in a month saying, who are you, where are you from, what do you do, that when someone says something like that, it just goes right by me, you know?
And you got a dollar! $1,000 for you. Robert, you're over here. Now, uh-oh. Let me show you what happened. This flipped on over to the 15 after I had said you won $1,000. So, the only thing we can do is to give her the $1,000 because I declared her $1,000. If it were golf, and the ball was on the lip of the cup,
and you had said now that the putt was not made, and then sometime later it dropped in the hole, it would still not be a putt. Is that not correct? Is there someone here from the PGA? Call your husband. He's a golfer, a professional golfer. Is that, that's 10 seconds, right. Well, I'm sure that 10 seconds passed, and we're playing by PGA rule. So she's won.
You did. You did. Now, just a moment. Just a moment. She turned to me in her excitement. She says, now, what do I do? What do I do? We know what she does, don't we? It's a triple what?
A pirouette. Oh, my goodness, no.
The moment has come. The stage is yours. George, just a moment. I am not going to fool with this. The principal will handle this.
She said she was going to do it. She's got to do it.
There you go. The principal has spoken. There's your music. There's your music. Terrific. And Principal George, you handled that beautifully.
Yvonne, in all the times that I have played Super Bowl, I have never had so puny a throw as that. Now, you are going to end up as one of my all-time disappointments if you do that again. Now, here's ball number one. You can win the refrigerator freezer with this. Now, come on, get it up there into that wind circle. Oh, boy. Now, just a minute, Yvonne. Let me have another talk with you. I didn't mean to make you mad. Now, you only got 50 bucks for that. I know you can do better. This is ball number two. With this, the entertainment cabinet. Now, come on, just right into the wind circle. Well, now, wait a minute. Now, this has never happened, and, you know, I wish, Rod, why did you call this woman's name? Why did you stick me with Yvonne up here? Now, I never before has this happened. Never before. But obviously, ladies and gentlemen, it is worth $50, because it couldn't do anything else, you see, except roll down here. See? I can't get my hand through that. All right, I'll tell you what I'll do. I'm going to give you another ball for that. That's what I'll have to do. Now, we don't have any other balls, do we? Yvonne, I'll never forget you. Now, with this is ball number three. Now, we're going to play like this is ball number two. And Diane, don't just stand there. Crawl around back there and find a ball. Go ahead, Diane, get back there and find a ball. Get back there and find a ball, Diane. Now, this is ball number two. You're trying for the shirts with this because, well, now wait. Maybe your hand's small enough to go through this screen over here on this side. Oh, you got one? All right. See? These girls are all right. They need direction, but they're all right. Now, this is still ball number two for the shirts. Go. I know it says three on it. Don't argue with me. Can you believe what's happening to me on this? I suppose you think you're going to get that over. Well, you're not. You're not. Already you've had more rolls here than anyone in the history of the game. She's throwing every ball all over the place and won 50 bucks. That's one. Now, come on. This is ball number three. This is for the camera. You seem to understand. You roll it up the thing. I beg your pardon?
Not throw it.
No. Why do you think I had you practice? I showed you how to do it. All right, now, believe it or not, and this will be difficult to believe. Believe it or not, you could still win all three prizes. And
I hate to even think about what might happen if she gets the Super Bowl. Now, to win the Super Bowl, with which you could win all three prizes, is that paint $36 or $48? What is it?
36.
36. All right. Now, you take that Super Bowl. Take the Super Bowl. Now, let me show you. You roll it up there. Didn't you? Don't you remember how I practiced? All right. Right. Now roll it, and if you get this into the... Just a moment. I don't think she understands the significance of this ball. If you get this in the wind circle, you win all three prizes. Sailboat, entertainment cabinet, refrigerator, freezer. Now get it in the wind circle. Well, you got 50, so you get three times that, 150. You win $200, and I'm going to have thousands for a psychiatrist after having you on the show.
If she wins these drums, some of the people will probably move out of Newport, Richie.
I don't know what to do.
You'll have to learn to play them. Of course you will. What is the price of number one? $2,222. What is the price of number three? The price of number three is $2,500. That's a Holly trick. That's right. It's usually a Holly. That's right. Holly who usually does that. No, we can always depend on Kathleen. I mean, I can't remember her ever doing a thing like that before. What did you say? Right? It's $2,513. You understand?
Yep.
Write that check, Timothy.
Either Timothy is a particularly bright contestant, or that was one of my better explanations because he understood it immediately. No, write the check over there. Turn my back on him for a moment. $2,900. There he goes, $2,900. You know, will we change the cover here, or will we just leave that? And in the years to come, that little black dot will remind us of Timothy forevermore. In the years to come, when we're playing this game, some contestant will say, "What's that little black dot there?" And I'll say, "Oh, that's Timothy's dot. That's Timothy's dot there." All right, put that $2,900 here. That's the amount of the check, $2,900. What is the price of that bed? $27.48 for a total of $56.48. You've won the money and you've won the bed. Well done, Timothy. Timothy is a winner. And remember, there's Timothy's little dot right there in the tooth. We'll be back after these words.
Out of their minds if you win this. An Lincoln! A Lincoln Mark 7 LSD two-door. Roomy, luxurious, a pleasure to ride in. Includes all the standard features, plus these options: anti-theft alarm, traction lock axle, automatic dim mirror, Ford JBL audio system, and California emissions.
Can you imagine the excitement if you win a Lincoln Mark 7, Jacqueline? Can you imagine the excitement? Now, each number here is just one away from the right number in the price of the Lincoln. Is the first number a one or a three? One, he says one. Second number, a zero or a two? Two, and the next number of seven or nine. Seven, how about the six? Five or seven? Coming up, you want to change the two to a one or a three? What do you say, Jacqueline? One. You have a price there of $12,751. Now look, Don't start throwing things. You might hit me. I want you to ask them, gentlemen, do I have at least one number right?
Gentlemen, do I have at least one number right?
I thought for a horrible moment you had no numbers right. Was that a horn? No number right? Not one number right? That has never happened before. That has never happened before. You know, the fact that it has never happened before, I didn't know that's how it had to happen once before. Once before. And the thing is, Jack, the reason the audience was so upset with you is that a Lincoln Mark 7, you can't get one with a 1, the first number in the prize. Oh, no, not that. But here we have, you see, $30,973.
I have been around a long time, as some of you know, but I've received a rather unique request, one so unique that I have decided that I shall grant this request. I am going to step down here. Robert, will you stand up, please? Robert, I understand you have a question you'd like to ask.
Yes, Heidi. I know we spent all our money on our vacation, and I don't have enough money to buy you a ring, but will you marry me?
I want you to know, this is the first prize on The Price is Right today. Congratulations,
thank
Robert.
You very much.
I wish you all the happiness in the world.
Tell me that one number and we'll give you that car.
Did you say that there's another one?
There's another one there someplace.
In the price of the car?
Yes.
One.
One. She says one. Is it one? Oh, the one is $8.21. What was the number she needed here? 3. Trudy, I'm sorry. Yes. We will be back with our second game after this message. Before we go on here, during that last commercial, we had a look at the tape. I didn't, but they did in the booth. And it seems that Trudy, I had told her that there's another one someplace on the board. And we started playing the game. Then later she asked me, is there another one? And I thought she meant on the board. I said, yes. She said, is there another one in the price of the car? And since I said, yes, there is, she took the one. So we're going to give Trudy the car anyway. We're going to give Trudy the car anyway. Now, who's our next player, Rod? Mercury Villager, you're standing on 2, which is the first number in the price. Light that up, please. No? No, I'll bet you can get the next. I'll bet. Look at him. I haven't even explained the game, and he stepped over to the one. Now, why would he do that? You know what? We're going too far with this give her the car anyway stuff, aren't we? That's what I started to say is I want you to step to the next number in the price of the car, and obviously you have. But if you should make a mistake later, you can win another chance by telling me the price of one of these prizes. What are these, Rod?
Well, Bob, let's begin with Varnado Whole Room Humidifier. Conditions the air all year round with just the right amount of moisture. Make yourself comfortable with Varnado. And sing along with your favorite artist or alone with this karaoke machine. Has an AM/FM radio, dual cassette, VHS video system, echo voice control, and pre-recorded audio-video tapes. Finally, from Daisy's Color Collection, a multi-cooker with removable crockery, temperature control, non-stick interior, and immersible Daisy.
Very well. Now, I would have pointed out what might have been the second number in the price of the car, but it won't be necessary since he's standing on it. $21,000 automobile. Now, the next number in the price is the zero in front of you, the eight over here on your right, or the two behind you. Eight. That's it. $21,800. And now, the next number, Keith, is the four in front of you or the nine behind you. Four, and he's right again. You know, I think the operator took one look at Keith and just thought, why, this guy knows these numbers. Why not light them up? So he gave him the first one. Now you're down to the last number, and look, this has happened very few times. Very few times. About three. About three times in the history of our show, in the history of this game, has a contestant lighted up every number without having to use at least one prize for another chance. If you can, you'll be one of our all-time champions if you can get this last one. Is it the five in front of you or the zero? Now, wait. Zero on your left. The five or the zero? Now, wait a minute. You've got this lighted up here. You got this so screwed up, nobody can play it. What's broken? All right, the zero won't turn off. So it is as a possible ability of a zero. All right. It's a zero or the five. Oh, back to the four. Now, you know where to step. All you have to do is win another chance. You want to use the humidifier. How do you pronounce that? Karaoke? The karaoke machine or the cooker?
Cooker.
All right. Is that cooker $35 or $65?
$35.
It's $35, Janice. No! $65. Now, humidifier or karaoke machine?
Humidifier.
Humidifier, $99 or $120?
$120?
What do you say, Keith?
$120? $120?
$120. Oh! Now, from the glorious position we were in moments ago, we are down to the real nitty-gritty. You have to get the karaoke machine right or you lose the car. Is the karaoke machine $70 or $90? What do you say, Keith? $70 or
$90? $90.
$90. Oh, he lost the car. I'm sorry, Keith. What? Well, just a moment. One moment. Just one moment. I am as disappointed as you, but I don't want to hear one of you say, give him the car anyway. We'll be back up again. Now, I'll tell you what I'm going to do. There's something been troubling me, and I'm thinking back to that game you played, Pathfinders. Although I said that it's the zero or the five, they had lighted up the zero, and he had three chances, I know, to win another chance when he made the mistake, went to the zero, but he went to the zero, and he lost the car, and I don't feel right about it, and we're going to give you the car. Come back here, Allison. You get one spin now. Be sure you get it all the way around or it doesn't count, and you don't get to spin again. $5,000 for a green section. $10,000. Go ahead, spin it. $10,000 if she gets that dollar again. $5,000 more. $5,000 more. And we'll be in the showcase at the end of the show. And if you want to join us for a taping of The Price is Right, listen to Rich.
If you would like to see The Price is Right in person, send your request, including the number of tickets and the date you wish to attend, along with a self-addressed stamped envelope to Tickets. The Price is Right, CBS Television City, 7800 Beverly Boulevard, Los Angeles, California, 90036. Back to you, Bob.
More pricing games after this announcement. Now, you folks may not have noticed, but usually in a bonus spin, we start the wheel on the 5 cents. You remember that? I had it on the dollar when we started there. So she got the 10 cents above the dollar. Had she started on the five, she would have got the dollar, so we're going to give her $10,000. $10,000. Yes. Now, and it goes to one of you four who bids nearest to the actual retail price without going over. Michael, what do you bid?
$1,200, Bob.
$1,200. How about it, Nathan?
Looks Victorian. I'd like to bid $50,000.
$50,000? $50,000?
Yeah.
All right. Eric, give me your bid.
$750.
$750. And now, Cynthia. The highest bid,
$50,000. No, I mean the second.
$1,200.
$1,200?
$1,201. $1,201. The actual... Nathan, where are you from?
St. Paul, Minnesota.
From Minnesota?
It's me.
What kind of prices do you pay for...
The economy's been tough. Prices, Bob. Prices, I don't know.
What town do you live in?
St. Paul.
St. Paul. What is the median price of a house in...
Probably about
$160,000. $160,000. And you think that was $50,000.
My first time on TV, Bob. I don't know.
He says he's going to start small. That's probably a pretty good strategy. What do you want to buy first?
I'll take 10 eggs, Bob.
10 of the eggs? Each egg is $2.19. How much is 10? $21. You're over. And he was thinking small, but you know Nathan. You think big. $70. Yes, you got it. It's not dropping properly. There it is. All right. In the price of the luggage, three numbers. Is that right? What do you suppose is the price of the luggage? $740. You're right. You've won the luggage. Now, in the price of the car, let me see. There are five numbers. Get busy. He believes the first number is one. Next number is four. 14,000. 14,700. 14,700. No, yeah, well, now wait, you skipped that one, yeah. 14,795. Very well. Hold the microphone. Let's get around here. You can't.
Please fix my dress.
She's falling apart. There. I got her. You won't believe it. I clipped her to my coat. And now she's clipped. Now she's all... Oh, you fell apart. Oh, forget it. Forget it.
And what do you bid on that fireplace? What do you bid on it? What do you bid on that fireplace? I say, what do you bid? Just a second, I can't hear. What?
I'll be all right.
You will be all right. I know you'll be all right. You look all right. You are all right. But what do you bid on that fireplace? How much do you bid? Now that is a very bad question. You know, she says, which fireplace? What did you say about that fireplace?
It's a mom fireplace. It's a freestanding fireplace.
It's a freestanding fire. Oh, they're going to go get a shot. They're going to shoot it backstage for it. Now look at your monitor. Where can you see a monitor? Let's see. Where can she see a monitor? Back up, and then you can see the audience monitor. Can you see it?
Over there.
Here it is. Here's the fireplace, see? Now, what do you bid on that?
$2,000.
All right.
The clock will start with your first bid, Tracy.
$950.
Lower.
$850.
Lower.
$750.
Lower.
$600.
Higher.
$700.
Higher.
$725.
Lower.
$710.
Higher.
$715.
Higher.
$716, $18,
$19,
$20, $21, $22. $710.
Higher.
$711.
Higher.
$12.
Higher.
$13, $14, $15, $16, $17.
You got it. $17. I tell you, this show is filled with surprises. It really is. Why would you go 7, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 18? Why? Why? I'm going to start drinking early tonight. You know that? Why? But you have won. You have won the first prize in about 11 seconds, and I mean 21, or whatever, you're close. About 21 seconds. And I have a feeling she's going to get it within this 9 seconds. Now, take a good look at that air bike.
Okay.
Take a good look so that you can give me a good first bid and show the prize. And the clock will start with your first bid on the air bike.
$950.
Lower.
$850.
Lower.
$750.
Higher.
$800.
Lower.
$775.
Higher. Higher.
$780.
Higher.
$790.
Higher.
$91, $92, $93, $94, $95.
$7.99. If the price had been $7.95, she would have got it. But I wish you a Merry Christmas,
Thank
Tracy.
Thank you.
Showcase Showdown coming up after this message. I tell you what. Perhaps I have become, I've become overcome with the Christmas spirit. But I am going to make a suggestion. In that last game there, in the clock game, you know, when she went on 7, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 18, you know, went on to, so she went so fast that I could not possibly get in the lower at until she'd gone on 18, 19. So with your permission, we'll give her both prizes anyway. Now, why, you may ask, and don't think at home if you get in clock game, it's going to be this easy all the time. But why, you may ask, would he do that? Because of this. She came so close to winning the second prize. Had she had a few more seconds from the first prize, she might well have won both prizes. Now, believe me, if it weren't Christmas, we would never do this, you see.
John, what's the next name on your list?
Vav is K. Kakoa. Come on down. You're the next contestant on the Price is Right. K. Kakoa, I welcome.
welcome you to contestants row, and unexpectedly, to me at least, I did not expect it. It's not K-A-Y or K-A-Y-E, it's just the initial K. Is that your first name? What do you have here? Oh, my God. Is all of that your first name?
My mother had a good sense of humor.
Well, she must have. Her name is K-A-M-U-K-E-A-L-E-I-A-N-U-V-E-N-U-E-K-I-P-A-L-I-L-E-I. And that's half of it. That's half of it. Is that a Hawaiian name?
Kamu Kea Lea Nui Nui Ke Pali Lele Lani Manoi Tiare.
Now, wait a minute. I don't think... Just a minute. She can't say that on television, can she, huh? What is your first name again?
Kamu Kea Lea Nui Nui Ke Pali Lele Lani Manoi Tiare.
Well, it's a pleasure to have you with us, Kay. It really is, and I can see why they have just the letter K.
On your mark. Get set. I didn't say go, Alan. Now, that's one false start. One more false start and you're disqualified.
I'm ready.
All right. On your mark. Get set. Go, Alan. One right, three wrong. All right, pull it. One right, three wrong. Come on, Alan. Now pull it down. Two right, two wrong. He still has 27 seconds, which I'll explain later. One right. Keep going, Alan. I tell you, he's getting more chances than any contestant who ever played racing. All right. I guess that's it. The time is up, Alan. Put that in place. I tell you what I'm going to do. This thing, you see, didn't start when you started. It didn't start, Alan. It failed. There was a mechanical failure, and I thought they were going to let you go on and on and on. But no, they rang the bell when you had about 15 seconds left, you thought. You were confused, weren't you?
I was very confused.
You were confused. And rather than have you leave this stage and tell the people back in North Carolina that I allowed you to become confused, I am going to give you all four of those prizes. Showcase Showdown, number one, after this. And the game for you is Cover Up. Here is a prize for the Chrysler LeBaron, which is not correct. The correct number is here or here. For right here, the first number in the prize. The second number is this one, or this one. The third, this, 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 or this, and so on. I want you to cover up the wrong numbers with the right numbers. Get busy, Nora Dean. She says the first number in the prize is one. And now, what about the eight? Okay, go right ahead, Nora Dean. 18,400. And what? 471. Three? Very well. Right back here, Nordine. You say the price of that car is $18,473. Is she right? Yes! She got it exactly right. $18,473. That's wonderful. I don't believe that has ever happened before. Congratulations. That's right. Loosen up.
That's all right.
I'm happy for you. I'm happy for you, but I can be happy back here. She jerked my right arm out there so badly I'll never write again. Now I can't use my left arm either. No, Goodbye, Marilyn. We'll be back after this.
I'll go with the nine.
He's going with the nine. He's going with the nine. I haven't asked you, where do you live?
Sacramento.
You live in Sacramento?
Yes.
You lived in California all your life?
Yes. And I watch you all the time. I love you, Bob.
I love you too, Devin. And Devin, I got a kiss and I haven't even given you the hole. Yeah. Now, this sweet young man gave me a kiss. Make it a, what did you say, nine? You said nine. It's a nine. You won that prize. More than $80,000 in prize. He's a winner. Congratulations, Devin. Another game after these words.
Discovered that there is an uncommon number of people in the audience having birthdays today. And we have decided that this is a birthday party. This isn't just the Price is Right today. It's a birthday party. Anybody have any candles with you? No candles? Well, what can we do? Let's light Roxanne here. Yeah, it is your birthday, is that right, Jan? And your daughter's birthday, who's here. And your husband's birthday. Do you have anyone in your family who's your birthday? Will you go back to your seat then? Because this is a birthday party.
During that message, Carol Burnett joined us, much to the delight of our studio audience. And it's appropriate because this is the stage that you were on for all those years.
Yes, this is the best stage in town.
That's right. Yeah. We were just saying, this is the stage that she did her show on that you loved all those years. Now, before you leave, you've got to ask Rod Roddy the name of our next player. Will you do that?
Yes. Okay, Rod, could you tell us the name of our next player?
Oh, I could, Carol, but I simply must tell you that I love you, and I thought you were just wonderful and noises off.
And big hand for Carol Burnett. Thank you.
Scott, what is that group you're here with?
I'm getting married Saturday, and they're all at the wedding party.
The wedding party is here. Let's have the wedding party stand up there. There they are. Now, Scott, most important of all, where's the bride?
She's working.
Can you believe this? What's her name?
Stephanie.
While poor Stephanie is slaving away, laughing boy here, gets the wedding party together and goes out to see The Price is Right. Tonight, Stephanie will call him, "How'd your day go?" "Oh, tough. I worked all day." Scott, I can tell now how this marriage is going to go. I've just arrived out here. And already I have a problem. Can you get a shot of this second contestant here? I have no idea who she is. She has Angela on her twice there. You see that? Why do you have your name tag on twice? Thank you. Thank you. The problem is worse than I imagined.
Odd. What's the next name on your list?
I make it out to be Alfreda Anderson. Come on down. You're the next contestant, Alfreda, on The Price is Right. Where are you? Alfreda Anderson. Yes.
Here she comes. Alfreda, where are you? Oh, look, here comes Alfreda. She came up some steps over there by Rod's podium. Alfreda, you've taken a shortcut.
I have.
You've taken a shortcut, yes. Now, you must go down here. Rod, you help her down there, will you please? You go down there in the contestant's row to start. Maybe you'll be right back up here.
Rod's going to fall on her now as she goes down the steps. There, you get down there, Alfreda, and get set in contestant's row. Right here's your spot. I have to admit, that was pretty slick what you tried to pull off there, Alfreda. I've had a lot of them come up these steps, you know. Not stopping contestant row, but not Alfreda. She thought, I'll come up those steps over there and he won't know where I came from.
Just noticed I came out and I was so anxious to get the show started that I didn't really check. But I have checked during that commercial. You two take a few steps back, will you please? You see, don't they look like, step back there a little bit, don't they look like the cowgirls from the Dallas Cowboys
yeah.
or something, huh?
Yeah.
I'll tell you what. Have you ever been cheerleaders?
No.
Have you? Get back there. You can do the Price is Right cheer. Turn, get the audience. We'll have yay price, yay right. Yay, the price is right. Get them, go. Come on. Yay, yay price, yay right. Yay, yay, the price is right. Come on, let's hear you do it. Let's hear you do it. Turn around there. All right.
That. You know, that's something to think about.
Our next player is Henry Louise Washington. Come on down. You're the next contestant on the Price is Right.
Your first name is Henry? Now, step over there. I can't hear
you. I told my mom when I turned 18 I would never use my first name because I didn't like it after my grandfather.
Well, now, whose idea? Well, your mother and your father decided to name you after your grandfather even though you were a girl.
Right. Henry Louise.
Henry Louise. Who's Louise?
That's my middle name.
I know. No. But where did it come from? Who?
I don't know anyone else. I don't know anyone else with it.
Well, Henry Louise, it could have been, well, you could have been Henry Clarence, you know. And here we are back to James Chisholm.
876.
They might know something we don't know, James. Oh, you know, you know. Well, I am going to know in a moment. The actual retail price of the juvenile furniture. Did that ring? Somebody was exactly right? Did you hear it? I didn't hear it. I didn't hear it, but I sure heard that. I have never heard that sound before. Well, the last time I was arrested. It was the last time I heard that sound. Now, I heard a horn. Now, this. What are they doing back there? Are they trying out all their new sounds or something today? I'm hearing sounds I've never heard on this show before. And if I don't stop, we're going to have a new sound man pushing the buttons back there. That's a sound I've heard before, that one. One of you is exactly right, and you receive a $100 bonus for a perfect bid. It is the contestant who bid $1,300, Mary. There you are, Mary. That is a $100 bonus for a perfect bid. What?
It's the wrong contestant. It's $1,350.
No. $1,350. $1,350. Tina. Mary. What a blow. Oh, what a blow, Mary. Where's that? I have to. Oh, and it was my fault. It does say $1,350. Well, now, wait a minute. The only excuse is old men make mistakes like that. I'm sorry. I'll tell you what. Roger, get a $100 bill for Mary. Roger. Roger's in charge of $100 bills, and we'll give you a $100 bill, too. And the next time I make a mistake, why, I hope it's for less money. Now,
is it any wonder that there are so many young ladies in the United States who would like to be Barker's beauties? Here's Holly just lying around in bed in her jammies all day and getting paid for it. Can you believe it? Now, Angela? No, Angela? After 18 years, I can tell when my little body is in danger. No, 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 you don't. No, 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 you don't. All right. Now, Angela, I want you to see something. I'm going to show you something. But before I do, you must promise that you're not going to hurt me.
I promise.
All right, raise your right hand. This is your right hand. I. Angela.
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 Promise.
Promise.
That I will not lay a hand on Bob Barker.
That I will not lay a hand on Bob Barker.
When he shows me the prize that he has to offer me.
Oh.
Now. Word for word, when he shows me
when the... When he shows me the prize.
That he has to offer me.
That he has to offer me.
There you are. Oh. Now you stay right there. And Angela, Angela, look. A new car! Angela, now, remember your promise. Turn around, Karen, and let's start showing Karen prizes, please.
A collection of appliances. The French touch and kitchen appliances from Moulinex. Deluxe 11-piece kitchen machine, large capacity deep fryer, turbo hand blender, versatile juice extractor, and patented universal can opener. Or the station wagon!
Higher?
Higher! Right you are. You get a chip. Put it by one of the shelves. No! That's the dirtiest trick anyone ever pulled on me. Now, wait a minute. Do you mean to tell me that after picking that up and looking under there and seeing that there's no ball there, you're going to put the chip beside that shell?
I laid it down.
That's dumb. Now, you don't have to do that. That's sweet. You're an honest girl, and I appreciate that, and everybody's proud of you. It's your ethics and your morals and all that. But don't do that. You cheated and got away with it. Now, don't put the chip by that shell, because, you see, you looked under there. There's no ball there. So, obviously, it's by one of those.
Lower.
Lower. You're right again. Where are you going to put... Oh, you're going to put that there. You know, I'm pretty sure she's won this. Didn't win it with that one, did she? Didn't win it with that one, did she? Boy, this is exciting now, isn't it? You know, you've ruined my show. You've ruined my game. This would be exciting. But everybody knows the damn thing's not there. It's here. You win. Congratulations. You're a wonderful contestant. Now. What'd you say?
I said, let's roll.
Let's roll. All right, what is the price of the cookware? Oh, you're in trouble. You are in trouble. I don't think we're rolling far beyond this. What's the price of the luggage? See, they don't want to show it. Kick it. Kick it. Kick it. There you go.
Come on, baby. Come on.
That's the way I make all the repairs at my own home.
This is nice.
It's a new van.
Oh, beautiful. Look, she hit it. Just look at this. I know what you're thinking.
You're thinking, gee, that's never happened before. Janice, now don't come. Can you come over here? So we can.
Hey, what happened?
Don't try to explain this.
I'll tell you exactly. We rehearsed it with the door closed, and now it's open.
Yeah. And Yes, Janice. Once before, in the same game, she came rolling out, and she's smiling at the camera and ran into that wall over there. You know, before you do this again, we're going to have to give you a driver's test. Now.
900, higher. 950, higher. 1,000, lower. 975, higher. 976, 97, 98, 99. Higher. 901, higher. 902, 903, 904, 905, 906, 907, 908, 909. 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14.
It's 999, Robert, and you are all over the nines, but not on a 999. However, did he say 999? Did he say 999? Now wait a moment. Did he say 999? Is anyone here? All right, I'll tell you what we'll do. We'll go into a commercial. While we're in the commercial, let's look at the tape, because he was jumping around. If he said 999, he's a winner. Did he win? Yeah. Did he not? We know he won one. Did he win? This is a cliffhanger. This is just what television likes. Do you think he has won both prizes? Did you hear him say 999? Stay with us. There's more Prices Right coming up. And when Robert was bidding on the dinette set, he said 976, 977, 978, and then he just said 99. So we're going to assume that he meant 999, and give him the dinette set. And give him the dinette set. Now, tune in tomorrow and see the rest of the show. Bring her the Super Bowl and put that Super Bowl in that win and you get them all. Oh, my goodness. You know, I'm glad there are no more balls. She could hurt herself in this game. Kate.
When? What's the price? 44, that was quite a drop, you know that? He didn't hit bottom. I was going on before he hit bottom. He's in bad shape. Oh, no, don't. We don't want to see him.
Okay, showdown. Just a moment. We have a serious situation here. Jacqueline cannot concentrate because she thinks her hair is messed up, and she wants the hairdresser. Lana, get your comb and come out here, will you please? And your hairspray. Lana, we're waiting for you. Where's Lana? Lana, we have a hairdresser standing by for emergencies just like this. Lana, come out here. This Jacqueline needs help. Here's the lovely Lana. The lovely Lana. Go right ahead. Fix her up. I want her to concentrate on the wheel, and she says she can't concentrate because she's afraid her hair is messed up. There you are. Jacqueline, you're going to look better than you have ever looked in your entire life when Lana gets through with you. There you go. Little spray. Let's hear it for Lana. Thank you, Lana. Michael, I don't believe that you were paying any attention when I was having a little discussion with the audience during that last commercial.
I wasn't.
No.
I was.
You are from Georgia.
That's right.
And there are a group of young people here with whom you are traveling.
That's right. This is my roommate. We go to school up in Pasadena, and we all go to church together, except we skip today.
Yes. They wanted me to ask you something.
And what was that?
Well, it's terribly personal.
And if I ask him that question, he's going to be spending a lot more time in church than he has been. I'll whisper it to him. I'll whisper it to him. He's becoming depressed. Just think of it.
I'm going to kill Charlie, my roommate. He's a dead man.
Well, now everyone at home feels cheated, but it seems that he is a very busy boy. And there's some doubt as to where the bracelet he won will go because there are endless girls he could give it to. But that's something for him to work on.
A showcase showdown.
This could be one of television's really big moments. During that commercial, I was talking with the audience, and someone mentioned the fact that we had some people do the tush push on the show. I walked back here. Ruth said, I teach the tush push, among other dances. I said, could you get these two to do it? She said, of course. So, now you tell them what to do, and let's do it. Come on, you two. Here you go. That's right. Ruth's upset that Grace Graziella didn't do that. Come on, now watch her. You got that last bit there. Watch her. Go, Graziella. There you go. Yeah. All they needed was music. I'm sorry, we're not going to have time for the showcase showdown. I like this. Well, I guess we ought to. You could win so much money. So we will. Okay, Terry. Yeah. Oh, my goodness. You all right?
I'm fine.
Goodness say. She banged herself. 45 cents. You want to spin again? I don't know whether you should or not, even if you want to.
I know.
You're going to stay on 45 cents? Huh? 45. Oh. All right, you're going to spin again. Now, carefully. Don't get your face over there again. No, your hair looks all right. You want it done?
Well, no.
Lana! Come on, Lana. Where's Lana? Lana, Leo can't go on now because his hair doesn't look as nice as Jacqueline. Here he is up here. There you are, Leo.
This is all Bob's idea.
Now, there you go.
It looks great.
It looks fine. Yes, but you weren't unhappy about it. There,
oh,
there you go.
Bless you.
Thank you. Do you want, here's a little on that one side there. There you are. You're looking great. Yes, you are.
Thank you.
Yes.
Wait, I think I have one hanging right down here, right there. Yeah, there. There you go. Bob Cisneros, maybe you better get his right there. Come over here, Bob. There you are. Just a little right on that one side, right there. There you go. There, we're all looking real cute now. Okay,